Have you ever got to a point where you feel like your Lightroom catalog is such a mess that you just want to declare a Lightroom bankruptcy and just start all over again? Well, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to show you how to organize your Lightroom library without having to just ditch everything and start again. And this is actually coming from a request I just received. And I won't say his name, but I'm just saying that he needs to, this is what he said. I need to resolve my problems with Lightroom. My problem is I never set up Lightroom as recommended. My folders are all over the place. I find images in more than one folder. And bottom line, I need to reload Lightroom and essentially start from scratch. How can I accomplish this and not lose my images? So this is a common question I actually get. Well, here's the good news. The good news is you're not actually going to lose any of your images because none of your images are stored in Lightroom. Your images are actually stored on your hard drive, and they're just managed in Lightroom. And in fact, there's a few areas I'm going to show you here which are going to help you just restructure and reorganize all your images. So if we look on a side here, we're in the library module right now. And if you look at the, we have catalogs, the first thing you want to do is click on all photos. So this is loading in every single photo right now that I have loaded into this Lightroom catalog. So then you're going to go to folders. And then when you look at folders, I'm just going to put the navigator up so we can see it better. So these are my folders here. You can see, you know, there's a lot of different stuff going on here. This is the actual directory structure. You can see it says Macintosh HD, which is my Macintosh hard drive, my main hard drive. And, you know, there's other drives in here. Here's my G-RAID, which is my external drive. Okay, so here's the thing about this. If you try to go in here, this is where they are stored on your computer. And if you look in your Finder or you go into your file manager, you're going to find them stored exactly the same as they are here. Now, if you try to move these images around on your computer, like going in Finder or anything like that, what's going to happen is it's going to mess it up because Lightroom is not going to know where those images are. So if you are going to move them around, what you want to do is you want to make sure that you do it through Lightroom. So say, for example, I've got my Mac drive here and I can see, you know, I've got 19 images on the desktop. I've got 12 in the pictures folder. Let's click on pictures and I can see those are 12 there that are stored on my hard drive under the pictures folder under Mac HD. But if I want to move these to a different location, what I'm going to do is I'm going to select them here. And I want to move these or relocate them. Control A or Command A to select them all. And I drag that into drag racing. Now, I'm going to move these. I'm going to click here. Now, notice what's going to happen. Two things are going to happen. One, this pictures folder. They're going to start moving. You're going to see up here, moving files. You'll see the move. Notice that number's getting less in there because it's actually moving these, relocating them. And if we look down at the drag racing, notice that number is increasing. So what's happening right now is we're moving the images from that hard drive that's on my computer to my external hard drive. So if you want to move your images around, this is the best way to do it. Do it right here. Notice the pictures folder. There's nothing there. I can delete this folder now if I want because there's no pictures in there. See that? And if we go back over here now, and this is the G-RAID Studio, which is my external drive, and I go down here to the drag racing, notice there's 12 images. These are the same images. I've just relocated them. So what you can do is go through different, like say, for example, I've got two ones here from Balboa. If I want to put these together, I'm just going to go in there, Control A or Command A to select them all. That's 97 images. And maybe I just want to drag them into Balboa 15. And I'll just click like that. And we can turn that off or you can just choose move to confirm it. And notice right now, I'm moving all of those out of that Balboa into this Balboa 15 folder now. See that? There we go. That folder is now empty. And I can safely remove that folder now. And those pictures are now living in here with those other ones. So you can start to organize your photos like that. Now, what that's doing is it's actually cleaning up what's on your hard drive. It's organized them into proper folders. Lightroom is still seeing these photos because you moved them within Lightroom. Once again, I'll emphasize, do not try to move these outside of Lightroom. If you try to move these outside of Lightroom, you will, they're not going to be erased, but you're not going to be able to find them. So that's the first step, is going under the folders, organizing your folders. The next step you want to do is go into collections. And collections are great. This is where I organize my individual shoots. You know, I've got one under here, under places, and you can see I'm able to create, you know, Balboa Harbor and Laguna in here. You'll see I've been there multiple times, or I've been to Laguna multiple times, and I can click on there and I can see the images. Notice I've got everything organized under shoots and locations. Now, in order to do this, it's really easy. You can do it a couple of ways. One is if you go to a folder and you want to actually make a, say here's my Osmo, here's all my pictures in the Osmo. If I want to create a collection of all my Osmo ones, I could just actually just click and drag that down there, and that will actually create a, so we'll see Osmo there is now there, and it's actually created a collection here. So these collections, all they're doing is referencing the images. If you wanted, another way you could do it is if you're trying to organize this and maybe you've got everything under this phantom folder and you want to organize by beach or whatever, you know, you can go down, you can hold the shift key, you can select, and then you can drag these into the collections. Or you can go under a collection here, for example, and I could select these and I could drag those into other collections. See, that's how you can organize things, by just dragging them around. So one of the strategy I do is I just create a collection called unsorted, and I just dump everything into that unsorted collection. And then you can use things like filters here by using text or attributes, maybe, you know, metadata, these different things. Sometimes you'll go by camera type. So here I can see, you know, hey, if I click here, there's the FC 300, which is, you know, one of my Phantoms. And if I hit the 350, look, there's my Inspire 1. So I can use these to go through the different cameras to organize those. You can go by focal length. You can go by different things to help you organize. You can use keywords. But the key here is to put them into collections. Here's another way you could do things. Is if we create a collection, and we'll just call this one testing. And this is another great tip you're going to love. So what I'm going to do on this testing one is I'm just going to right-click, and I'm going to choose Set as Target Collection. Okay, so that means that this is now Target Collection. So I can go into all my photographs now, and anything I want to add to there, all I got to do is see that little circle up there? I click on that little circle, and that will add these into that collection. So if I go there, and we look down here and we go back to our collection and we do our testing one. Look at this. Those ones that we've clicked on are now added to that collection. So you can always go back there, turn that off, and then once you've done that, it just goes back to the very top here, which is quick collection. Or, you know, we can also right click and set it to a target. So we can do that on any folder. And to remove it, just simply click on there. And then when we do that, that will be removed from that collection. You're not removing them from Lightroom. Just remember this. Everything in your Lightroom catalog is here. This is its actual location. Now we can make collections. Now these collections don't move the images. They don't duplicate images. All we're doing is we're just organizing them where we can find them. So when I click here, I go, oh wow, here's all these photos. So the collections are things that you create to help you find things. The folders are where they actually live on your hard drive. So hopefully this helps. And you don't have to restart, you know, just wipe out Lightroom and start all over again because it's such a mess. You can actually go through and you can use some different strategies and organize these yourself. Now, I have a really comprehensive training, the Lightroom for Digital Photographers series. Check that out. I'll put a link to that. It's a 13-hour video that has everything you need to know about Lightroom A to Z that will help you with organization and also adjusting. So a little tip, though, when you're importing things, maybe you want to, you know, when we click on import here, you have the options here to add to a collection when you're importing. That's one of the things I would definitely recommend doing, and I do that now all the time. And the other thing here is I'll add some keywords, just some basic keywords while I'm importing, and that will help me avoid this big, massive amount of work at the end. Do me a favor, hit that subscribe button right now so then you can become a subscriber and you'll get my weekly tutorials and different tips that I'm doing right now. Also, feel free to add a comment, you know, suggestions. For example, this particular tutorial came out of a question. So I'm very happy to do that. So anyway, thanks guys. I hope this was useful. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.